Hello everyone, my name is Pranshu and welcome to my channel. Before starting with this video, I would like to tell you something. Initially, I had planned to make just one video explaining how you can design your robot for ROS simulation. However, many of you guys requested me to make a detailed tutorial of designing software, and that was making video very long. So to cover all the details and not to make it a boring lecture of 1 to 2 hours, I have divided this series into 3 major parts. And this is the first part of the series. In this video, we'll look into the different softwares that we can use for designing our robot, and we'll see pros and cons of each of them. And later, I will tell you which software I personally prefer and the reason behind using it. In the further part of the series, we will see how we can design our robot and create their mockups, renders, and animations, and finally, how to use them into a ROS simulation. To make sure you don't miss out on those videos, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Ring the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload those videos. So without any further ado, let's get started by looking at the options of softwares that we have for robot designing. First in the list is the oldest and the industry favorite designing software, SolidWorks. As Wikipedia says, SolidWorks is a solid modeling design software which is published by Dassault Systèmes. It is the same group of companies which makes the controversial Rafale jets. Anyways, SolidWorks has been around for almost 25 years now. So we can say it's quite a mature software, and over these 25 years, it has been grown a lot with many feature additions over time, and it has been industry favorite right from the start due to lack of options. The company has used this lack of competition to put up an unrealistic price over the license of the software. Even the student version of the software costs you around 10k rupees for just 1 year, which is too much for an average student to bear for just a software. Also, it is quite difficult for beginners to learn. Due to these two major factors, I don't personally prefer SolidWorks. So to cater the high cost factor of SolidWorks, we have a really good and open source software, Blender. So yet again, as Wikipedia says, Blender is a free and open source software toolset used for designing, creating animations, visual effects, etc. Blender is a really good software which is widely used in animation and VFX industry. But the major strength of Blender turns out to be its own weakness in robot design. As Blender is used in animation, it is really good sculpting software. You can make really cool looking organic shapes using Blender. But when it comes to mechanical designing, Blender lacks a lot of properties. The results obtained by Blender for robot designing are not quite satisfactory, and also doesn't meet the industry standards. But I must say, it is a software worth learning to give cool aesthetic effects to your models. That brings us to our third option, creating or designing robot using URDF, which is directly supported by ROS. You might have not heard about this before, but URDF stands for Unified Robot Description Format. It is an XML file format that is used to describe your robot structure to ROS simulation environment. As the name suggests, it is a detailed description of your robot, right from the information about the links and joints to its inertial and mass values, and also friction and everything. Also, no matter which platform do you use for designing your robot, at the end, it is necessary to convert it into URDF so as to use it in ROS simulation. But designing a robot from scratch in URDF is really a tiring process. It also limits you from using complex structures which can be easily done in any dedicated designing software. You can definitely import meshes to make complex structures of your robot, but then aligning the links takes a lot of time. And that's the only reason I don't recommend directly making your robot in URDF. These were the few top robot designing software options. But before getting to the best software, here are a few honorable mentions. Tinkercad. Autodesk Inventor. Autodesk Maya, CATIA, PTC Creo. finally Autodesk One 2 3D design. So if you have reached so far, I'm pretty sure you really want to know how to design the robot with the best possible tool. So the software which I personally use and recommend to the people around me is none other than Autodesk Fusion 360. Fusion 360 is the first 3D CAD, CAM and CAE tool of its kind. It connects your entire product development process in single cloud-based solution, supporting the digital manufacturing process. It is supported on both Windows and Mac, unlike SolidWorks which is only supported on Windows. Fusion 360 supports all file formats, so no matter where it was first designed in. So if you have an existing SolidWorks file, you can still edit it in Fusion 360. Process of converting 2D drawings to 3D models and vice versa is really easy and quick in Fusion 360. Also, Fusion 360 design files are stored directly on Autodesk Cloud linked to your account. So you can access it from anywhere in the world from any system you want. For example, when I am here at my workplace, I design on my PC right over here, and whenever I go home, I can continue working on the design on my laptop. Also, there is no fear of losing your data, nor does it clutter your system storage. And as it is a cloud-based system, you can have a hassle-free collaboration on a single project between you and your teammates. It also has a mobile app which comes in handy to quickly view your designs on the go. With Fusion 360, you can design mechanical models, create organic shapes, and also animate and render high quality images and videos out of it. And yes, you can also perform stress, thermal, and manufacturing simulations on your models. By the way, this video is sponsored not by Fusion 360. For that matter, I would love to if they do so. But anyways, all what I have said is from my personal experience of using Fusion 360. Autodesk also offers a very useful educational license that allows students and educators to use the software's full version with almost all the functionality without paying a single penny for over 3 years. I'm using the same license right now. And if you are not a student or an educator, even then Autodesk provides a free to use personal license which is more than enough to get started. I will put all relevant links down in the description. So coming to the conclusion, I would like to say no matter what software you use, in the end of the day, your skills are what matters the most. Just using a specific software doesn't make you expert in anything. So along with software choices, do work on your skills too. I hope you found this video very insightful. If yes, then don't forget to give a thumbs up. Also, you are not bound to use just Fusion 360 or any other software which I mentioned. You can use any software you are comfortable with. And if you still choose to go with Fusion 360, I will be uploading a detailed tutorial on how you can design your robot in Fusion 360 and later use it in ROS simulation. So if you don't want to miss out on that video, make sure you are subscribed to my channel and ring the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload them. That was it for this video guys. I will see you in the next one. Peace.